How to update your Minecraft server to 1.19 or the newest version of Minecraft safely. And that's the thing we're going to be going over and stressing in this video. How can you update your server in the safest way possible? So first things first, I need to show you that this server is not joinable on the most recent version, 1.19, but it is on 1.18. So as you can see, we are in 1.18.2 right now and update this server. This is the server we're going to be updating. If we go ahead and join on into it, we will see that it is working. It's also the server we're joining on the left-hand side here where I need to opt myself. And once we're in game, I want to go into creative real fast because I want to show you that this is in fact the server that, join later as well. So we're going to use some gold blocks to do that really fast, right like so, and boom, that's going to be enough, right? These are gold blocks. These aren't normal. They shouldn't be here. So now we know when we join this later, that's going to still be there. But what happens if we try to join the server on 1.19? Well, let's go ahead. Jump cut to us having 1.19 open. As you can see, Minecraft 1.19 there as well as up here at the top left. And if we click multiplayer, it says 1.18. We double click on it and it says failed. Incompatible client. Please use 1.18.2. How do we fix that, right? How do we update our server? Well, let's go ahead and minimize Minecraft, and we want to come over here to our server, and if you've not stopped your server, you want to do so. So stop the server, close out of it right like so. Now, here is our server. This is it. This is it on the desktop. Before we do anything else, I want you to right-click on this folder, copy, and then right-click on your desktop and click paste. Is it going to copy everything on your server into a new folder? This is a backup. So I'm going to rename this Minecraft 1.18.2 server backup. And then we're just kind of move it out of the way, right? We're going to move it out of the way. Bottom left of the screen, doesn't matter. You just want to move it out of the way. Because we want to make sure that if something does go wrong in this update process, we can roll back. And you would do that by just replacing this folder, deleting it, and then going to your backup folder and using that as your main server. However, to update your server, you're going to need to download the updated .jar file. Now, if you're running a plugin server, you can download from paper, the most recent paper.jar. If you're running a vanilla server, which is what we're updating at the moment, you want to download the most recent vanilla.jar file. If you're running a modded server, same thing. You want to download the most recent version of Forge and get the Forge basically server set up and then transfer everything over. However, Forge is a little different, so wait to the end of the video if you're watching this. But for plugin servers and vanilla Minecraft servers, you want to download the most recent version of the server software you're updating for. So in our case, it's vanilla here. Now, this is linked in the description down below. This is MC Versions, and this is where you can download any version of Minecraft, all the way back to like version one, right? And you've got beta and you've got alpha and all that stuff. But we're going to download the latest release here. It's going to take us here. We want to click on download server.jar, and right away it downloads in the bottom left, right like so. Now, if we go ahead and minimize the browser, we can get this from our downloads folder. Do that by clicking the little Windows icon on the top left and searching for downloads. There it is, and in here we'll find the server.jar. Now, all we need to do is replace the server.jar in this directory with this server.jar. So let's go ahead and delete this one and add the new one in here. Now, if we go ahead and double click to start this server, it is going to start right on up. Right like so. Wait for it. It's starting. There it is. And it's going to update the server to 1.19. As you can see, it's 1.18 right now. If we wait for the server to start up, boom, refresh, and now we can join this in Minecraft 1.19. We're good to go, right? We can join on in here, and we'll see that our gold ore is there. That is how simple it is to update a vanilla Minecraft server. However, if you have plugins, this is going to work, right? What we just did is going to work, but your plugins won't work, right? Your plugins could still have issues. You're gonna need to go through and update every single plugin on your server to the 1.19 version. This is what delays some plugins and some big Minecraft servers from updating. All their plugins aren't updated. However, it is worth noting that at this point, most plugins are updated to Minecraft 1.19. So you will need to go through and redo and basically reinstall every single plugin on your server. Mods, those are a bit different. So let's talk about that. A modded server is structured a bit differently than a plugin server because mods also need to be updated in order to run basically the next version. So you'll need to update all of your mods. Be careful with that though, because when you're updating your mods to the newer version, let's take our Forge server here. We have a basically off screen 1.19 Forge server. Any mods that are in here might not actually update, right? They might not actually update for a long time. And if you just remove them and start your server, it will corrupt your world. That's why it's very important that you get a backup for a Forge server. It's very important no matter what, but you want to make sure that you have something to go back to because the chance of you successfully updating a modded server are very low. And for this reason, I would recommend you just starting a new modded server whenever you do update to a new version. Unfortunate, but that's just how it works. Plugin servers, vanilla servers, that's not required. But for forge servers and modded servers where they are adding things to the world, custom biomes, custom mobs, custom items, if every single mod's not updated, the chances of that world corrupting are very, very high. So like I said, I would recommend updating by just creating a new server and starting fresh. And that sucks, but it is what it is. Now, that being said, if you've only got three or four mods, feel free to update those, and it probably will be okay. But you want to make sure that you are on the 1.19 version of those mods the first time you start your server with Forge 1.19. Also, with the modded server, you may find that it's harder to do what we just did, and it would be better to create a 1.19 Forge server and then copy over all of these folders here. If you move over all of these folders, all of your data from your server is going to transfer to the new server. So basically, just create a brand new 1.19 Forge server and copy all of these files and folders over to that server. Just the folders, excuse me, all these folders over to that new server, and that should do similar things. But again, make sure you still need to update all of those mods. So hopefully that made sense, and hopefully that has helped you update your server. But there's one thing that we need to do here, and that's rename this. This should now be Minecraft 1.19 server, because it is updated. Thanks so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel for more incredible content every single day of the week. My name is Nick. This has been The Breakdown, and I'm out. Peace.